In this video, I'll show you how to set up a safety plane you can use as a strict limit or to trigger reduced mode. Start by navigating to the Features menu and create a point feature. Then move the robot TCP to where you want to create a safety plane. The plane will be created perpendicular to the Z-axis. The positive Z direction defines the restricted side of the plane. Save the point feature. Open the safety menu and select Planes. Enter your safety password and then select Add Plane. You can add up to 8 planes. Next, you have to associate this plane with the feature you have just created. Now you have created a safety plane, and you can choose which restrictions to apply to this plane. Normal prevents the robot TCP, defined in the Tool Position section, from moving beyond the plane when in normal mode. Reduced does the same, but only when the robot is moving in reduced mode. If you choose both, the restriction applies in both modes. When the TCP or elbow joint touches the safety plane, the robot triggers a protective stop. You can also use the safety plane to trigger reduced mode. In this mode, the robot can move through the plane, but must switch to the reduced settings defined in the Robot Limits menu. Normal mode is resumed when the TCP is no longer located beyond the safety plane.